my speech will be very personal, and for that I brought my little helpers with me, so just in case when I will fall out of my concept, I can hold me on this. So, when we want to go back to my soul, first of all, we have to go far back into 1964. I was born in 1964 in a little town in the southeast of the Alps in Switzerland. My father was a civil engineer and my mother a passionate family mother. I grew up with my older brother and my younger sister. And I was a totally normal baby. But when I was 4 years old, I realized that I was different. I had no penis, and for that, they perceived me as a girl. I was born female, biological female. I learned that there will never grow a penis, and for that, I can never change into a boy. This was one of my bitterest insights I had in my life. But then I found out that there are other cultures where men looked like women, wearing long hair, having no beard, and even they were still tough men. In my fantasy, I decided to become a Native American. I had a happy childhood. I loved to play outside, and my parents were very open-minded. I played in the woods, and I loved the animals and the flowers. I had a carefree life, and the little difference between my legs didn't really matter. But then, my puberty starts and everything started to change. My body changed into a direction I never wanted, and I felt very alone and misunderstood. They brought me to psychiatrists, but they didn't find out what really was going on in my head. I fought an inner silent battle with my soul and my body. A few years later, I started medical school in 1984. And then, for the first time, I found out the name for my inner conflict: transsexualism. I went to the library of the university. I looked up every book I found, but what I read was very disappointing and frustrating. At that time, to be transsexual meant to be mentally ill, and you will be abandoned by the society. They showed me a life between suicide and funny farms. Hence, I decided not to talk about this to anybody and try to make the best out of my life. I was well integrated. I had many friends, and I tried to live as a woman, more or less. Professionally, I played my female role, but in my free time, I could live my male identity. I found out that with a lot of sport, I could keep my body in shape. When I was on my own, I could escape from the female-male binary. I made a good career as a gynecologist. I opened my own praxis in 2007, and I was on the top of my life. I earned quite a lot of money, and I was independent. But then I asked myself, am I really happy? Is this my life? No, it was not my life, and I was not happy at all. I made my biggest decision in my life. I took heart and I started to write letters to my friends, to my patients, and even to my colleagues, and I explained that I want to live as a man, not only inside, but also outside. I started hormonal therapy, and my body responded very well and very fast to this treatment. After a few months, I could look into the mirror and I saw my soul on my face. But I was prepared for everything. Losing my friends, losing my family, or even losing my job. But fortunately, nothing happened to me. I was surrounded by people who helped me to make my dream become true. I got a lot of support and I could work in the same field at the same place here on Earth, the wonderful place here in Zug. So for me, it was the best way to go. I never regret my step. For me, it was the only way to go, to become true to my life. And I know there are many other people in the world, or in this city, or even in this audience, who want to be true to themselves and be what they really are. Could you imagine in this world that people get killed because of that, because they want to be true to themselves? It is a crime that every year hundreds of transsexual men and women have to die because they took heart to live in their other gender role than they were assigned to at birth. Only because they look different and do not fit into the gender binary or do not fit into the categories. We are all human beings with our wishes, our dreams, and our yearnings. And so it's very hard to understand that people who do not fit into categories has to be prejudiced by the people. I think we have break down the taboo of transsexualism. We have to go out and show how big the diversity of life could be. So for me, it is very important to stay here and to be in front of you as an openly transsexual man. I know I am a lucky guy and I had the chance to change my life with a lot of support. But there are a lot of other people in the same boat as I am and they are still struggling with their lives. They do not have the support of the family. They lost their jobs because they are transsexual and they had to move from their places because they had to escape from the people's prejudice. I think we have to become visible to gain acceptance. And with acceptance, we will earn understanding. And so I believe we can make the world a better place for all of us. I know I'm not the only one who came out at the public. I know there are many other brave transsexual women and men who stand up and started to talk about their life experience. I want to give you some examples. Jess Bono, he came out in 2008 as the transsexual son of the famous pop star Cher, and he is now an advocate for transsexual issues in the United States. Balian Buschbaum, he was in his former life a pole vaulter, a female pole vaulter, and he came out in 2007 and he wrote a famous book about his biography. And then the filmmaker Lana Wachowski, she was the director together with her brother for the film Matrix, Matrix Reloaded, and the recently released film Cloud Atlas. She came out last October in Los Angeles. All these people decided to make their life dreams become true. And they had the power to stand up and to go out and talk about their life experiences. So they can show us that we are all normal human beings. Being transsexual or transgender is not a matter of pathology, it is a matter of diversity. I know that I never felt as a woman, and today I cannot say that I feel as a man. But with the past years of my transition, I find out with my visible masculinity, it is not necessary anymore to see or to find if I'm more female or more male. I finally can say I feel as myself. I stay here in front of you because I want to encourage everybody to become true to his or her life and to accept the truth of everybody's life. Thank you very much for your attention.